அனைவருக்கும் வணக்கம். குட் ஈவினிங் டு எவ்ரி ஒன். மை நேம் இஸ் ஆஸ்லன். திஸ் இஸ் அ வாக் அரவுண்ட் அண்ட் ரிவ்யூ ஆஃப் ஆல் நியூ இனோவா கிறிஸ்டா. வி பர்ச்சேஸ் ஃப்ரம் ஆனமலைஸ் டொயோட்டா திருநெல்வேலி. திஸ் கலர் இஸ் அவென்டிக் கிராடே பிரான்ஸ். டாப் வேரியன்ட் 2.8 லிட்டர் ஜெட் வேரியன்ட். கலர் லுக்ஸ் டூ கூல் இன் கம்பேர்ட் டு others. I mean, it, based on our perception, the color looks too cool and great. Krista. On-road cost around 24.56 lakh after GST. With accessories, it comes around 26.5 lakh. Op variant, Z 2.8 Z variant. Auto transmission, auto torque converter. It's not neither a DSG nor CVT. It's a torque converter. It's a old school torque converter, but performs well. Headlight clusters. It has two LEDs, two light. This low beam is LED, high beam is halogen lamp with a jewel like arrangement of parking lamps. In night, make sure that you switch on both the low beam and parking light. As the width varies, if you switch on the parking lights alone, it makes a, it's the assumption of the oncoming vehicle that the size is too small. So always make sure to switch on both the low beam and parking lights. Hexagonal chrome grill, hexagonal grill. You can see the hexagonal structure over there with the chrome to the first two rows. Toyota logo. Notice a small detail over there, small detail, and chrome mirror. Roof ornament is accessory, and then 16-inch wheel with the higher sidewall of 205/65, which means 205 is the width of the tire, is the wheel base, and 65 is the 65% of 205 is the sidewall thickness. 16-inch wheel, radial tubeless tire, tail lamp, L-shaped tail lamp cluster, which looks cool at the rear. Total rear wash, rear wiper with washer in between. Actually, can't make it to focus over there. It's in this range. And then rear view camera with the sensors. The camera performs good. It gives it a wide view of the car, rear view car, wide view of the car. The rear view camera, it gives a view till here and also till over there. Cool, right? And then it's a diesel, 2.8 liter diesel. And is a front wiper with the washer liquid placed over here. I think you can see over there, there's a small gap over here. It sprays the washer fluid. There's a fog lamp cluster with integrated indicators and the huge air dam with the intercoolers. I think, I don't know whether it's visible to you. Yes, it's visible to you. Then just press the unlock button or smart entry system, the key in your pocket. Just smart entry system. It's a huge interior. The view, the doors wipes away. This is a puddle lamp. Once you unlock your vehicle, the puddle lamp glows so that you can stop any vehicle safely without anything. Puddle lamp. Once you lock this, the puddle lamp gets switched off. Once you unlock, it glows and you enter. It's a wide door easy ingress and egress. Sorry, it's not focusing. Yes, okay, fine. And this is a brown leather seat. It's a mix of genuine and synthetic leather. And have this electrically adjustable seat, recline, straight forward, go back, forward, height adjustment, thigh adjustment. You can see the difference. You can see the thigh adjustments, and a huge dead pedal. Okay, and then this is a 3D die instrument cluster with the MID screen at the center. Actually, the MID screen, it's identical to Hilux Fortuner. I mean, if you see the Fortuner, the same, I think the graphic user interface of MID screen will be the similar as of Innova Crysta as well as Hilux. You can see the same thing option. It's globally one. Range, current mileage, then music. You can choose the source from disc, FM, and USB. There is no USB 2. I don't know why they are mentioning USB 2 over there. And then the messages, like service messages, like if the service is that due, whatever. If there's any error, then the message will be there. And tachometer and speedometer. Infotainment, a huge 7-inch infotainment system with navigation. The navigation gives you the information of POI interest. Point of interest, and voice over navigation. The option is available in Tamil, English, Malayalam, Telugu, Kannada, Hindi, Marathi. There are various languages. I will show you once I make a separate video on infotainment system. And this is a sound quality is good for me. It's better for me. For the music enthusiasts, like music freakers, they find it difficult. They find to replace the speaker, but for me, it's far away good. Toyota OE speakers are far away good. There are two modes, Eco mode and Power mode. Once you press on Eco mode, there will drop in the power, drop in the throttle response and everything. But once you're in a Power mode, the response will be much quicker. Once you turn Eco mode, the Eco mode display will be on the Eco mode will be on the display screen. And once you are in the Power mode, you can see, that's the thing. And also you can notice one thing. When you are not in the when you are neither in Eco nor Power mode, neither in Eco nor Power mode, and when you are driving at a light throttle response and the speed till 100 kph, you'll find the Eco indicator over here. Right now we can't see. We need to drive. To drive it, I can't do because I'm the one I'm shooting. So I can't drive the vehicle right now. And you can see this is ambient lighting. You can increase the illumination of ambient lighting. This is an automatic transmission given by ASIN. AC60E. The model number is AC60E. The ASIN model is a subsidiary of Toyota. It takes 53% stake of Toyota ASIN gearbox. And the ASIN gearbox, it makes gearbox for BMW also, and recent SsangYong Rexton also had a ASIN gearbox, and Mahindra XUV500 automatic also had a ASIN gearbox, and Fortuner, Hilux,
Everything has a ASIN gearbox. Almost this Innova Crysta is made of TGV platform. It's a new platform in which Hilux and Fortuner were made. And the gearbox is this A60E means E, which refers to electronic trip. I mean, Triptronic is the electronic one. Same in Fortuner also. In Fortuner, in 4x4, it's AC60F, which means four-wheel drive. I mean, the differential axis will be connected to both sides to the... Wow.
Brown leather seats. It's automatic transmission. I mean, the higher Z variant has two engines, 2.4 and 2.8. 2.4 gives 154 horsepower. It's a manual transmission. This is a automatic transmission, 2.8 liter, 174 horsepower. And 343 newton meter of torque, and twin LED cluster, 3D dial. And this is the blue LED illumination, ambient lighting, and just show you. Let's remove the Sida Nova. Actually, if you see the instrument cluster, like the center MLED display, this is a MLED display. And if you compare with the Hilux or Fortuner in the Fortuner, the same, I think the same MLED display, the same thing you will get for Fortuner, Hilux or whatever. And this is a 3D dial, top speed 200 km per hour. Navigation system. I'll make a separate video on navigation system. And smart key entry system. And air conditioning system. This is working on video. Okay, let's start the engine, crank the engine. You can feel the vibration while starting in the engine, but the engine is refined while on the highway. When I'm cruising in the highway, engine is too refined. And you can see the small detail for it. You can set the start of image, and there's a procedure you need to refer the manual. You have to set the display of image, start of image. I'll cover it later while doing a separate video on navigation system. This is the audio quality. This card pen drive is connected over here. This is the rear view. Just so silent. Just pass the audio. Silent. Auto folding mirror, up and down. Then transmissions, reverse. Once you step on the reverse gear, you'll get the reverse lights. And drive mode, Triptronic function, one. Actually, it's in the maximum gear, it's S4, and gear goes up to S6, S1, S2, S1, first gear. So while you are inclining or declining, declining gradient or hill station, we'll go into hill stations. Actually, the Triptronic performs well. It holds the gear no matter at what rev range you are. Like say if you want a speed up around 20 kph, just shift to the manual mode. It's not actually sports mode, it's a manual mode. And make it to second gear. That's it. And you don't need to step on the accelerator. It will go. It will hold the gear. It gives you the engine braking. For the engine braking, it's suitable. And then I'll explain them. There are lots and lots of features. I'll explain it to you. Vanity mirror with lights, and even you get the passenger side vanity mirror with lights. And these are the illumination, blue, that ambient lighting illumination. Night looks too cool at night. And then same at the rear you have the blue light illumination. It looks far cool at the night. These are the accessories which you made. Okay. And this is a IRVM, but obviously it has a manual dimming mirror. Like for the 26 lakhs vehicle, had it offered me an auto dimming mirror. It's a manual dimming one, but it looks cool. It performs well, great. Air conditioning system, auto air conditioning system. It cools the cabin within a span of 1 minute. That's it. Even if you're in the hot sun of around 40 degrees or whatever, it cools the cabin, performs well. Show you the headlights. The LED lights, the jewel-like arrangement of parking lights. The low beam LED, it's the auto folding up, auto leveling option. Auto LED performs really great. All you just need to do is shift to auto mode, shift the stock to auto mode. Right now it's in manual. Shift to auto mode, that's it. Enough. While you are on the highway or cruising or you are being outside, you just know what it will do is, initially it will light the parking lamp, and then when you are switching, and if you have the option to switch off the fog lamp, glow it at also. Depending on the intensity of the outside light, say if the intensity of the light drops little by little further, so what it does is, depends on that, it switch on the low beam main light. Okay, so it's a cool function. Say for the time it's at 6 o'clock, that time the outside brightness, it will be little bit okay, fine. So at that time only the parking light it will glow, and when the light gets start dimming, outside ambient lighting gets start dimming, automatically the main light glows on. Okay, that's a feature of ambient auto lighting. Here are the sensors. I think you can see the sensor. One is for automatic climate control and one is for auto headlight. One test tumble seat. That's it. There's down button. Is there one test tumble seat? Third row. It feels very spacious even for the long highway. It's too spacious. I think this is the only car which offers you the best luxury in third row, last seat. And this is the ambient lighting. It really looks cool. Compared to the previous Innova, it's so far away. Okay, that's it.
This is an automatic transmission given by Aisin. AC60E, the model number is AC60E. The Aisin model is a subsidiary of Toyota. It takes 53% stake of Toyota Aisin gearbox. And the Aisin gearbox, it makes gearbox for BMW also. And recent SsangYong Rexton also had a Aisin gearbox. And Mahindra XUV500 automatic also had a Aisin gearbox. And Fortuner, Hilux, everything has a Aisin gearbox. Almost this Innova Crysta is made of TGV platform. It's a new platform in which Hilux and Fortuner were made. And the gearbox is this AC60 means E, which refers which refers to electronic trip. I mean, Triptronic is the electronic one. Same in Fortuner also. In Fortuner, in 4x4, it's AC60F, which I mean, everything is carried away from I mean, the Toyota, the speedometer cluster, everything. If you see, like between the Fortuner and Hilux, the instrument cluster remains the same for both Fortuner and Hilux. You can just review for Hilux review. You can review the international website Hilux review. The instrument cluster will remain the same. Innova Crysta is different, but the MID screen, the graphic user interface remains 100% same as to Hilux and Fortuner. Initial the startup screen will be different. In Fortuner, it will be different. In Innova, it is like this. Hilux, it will be different. And this is the all new Foxwood. Or falsehood, whatever may be. Okay. That's it. Let me go with the. .8 liter 1 GD engine, the intercooler.